Yo, what's good, YouTube? This is Jake from TNJ, and we're hopping back into Big 12 play here in the SJSU Dynasty, coming off of that huge victory versus UCLA. As you can just see, we are in the driver's seat, sitting here at number 3 in the country, 5-0, 1-0 in the Big 12. We have one of the top defenses here in the nation, have been shutting teams down to start the year. So here is BYU. We did move them over to the Big 12 to kind of make it a balanced conference and give the Big 12 a conference championship, because I believe you have to have 12 or 10 teams in each conference to have a conference championship. So we do want to kind of level the playing field for the Big 12. So here is a throw out to the left side to start this game, and that's deflected by Marcus Daniels as we do get the punt right away here to start this first game. So here's a throw out to the right, starting Tulevski out, throwing out to Raheem Makusi, 17 yards on that throw, and that's a big first down. So now from the shotgun, here's Tulevski, a deep shot to the left side, and that's going to be picked off by Johnson, the safety. That was not thrown in the correct position. That was actually thrown across the middle and up the seam. And for some reason, Tulevski, that throw was way off. So now we do get the ball back later in the first quarter. Here is Jordan Armstead getting open for a 26-yard gain, and that's going to be a catch and run for a first down. Here is Sammy Baldwin getting involved early on in this game as well. 21 yards for him on that out route. So now facing a 3rd and 10, some more pressure. Here is Sammy moving the ball upfield, and he's going to make it to the first down marker, getting pulled down by his face mask, but that's going to be a no call. So we do eventually get inside the 10 here on a 2nd and goal. Tulevski throw across the middle. That's Raheem, and he's in for 11 yards out for the touchdown. And Tulevski starts out pretty nicely, 7 for 14, not the best completion percentage, but a nice start. So now here in the second quarter, as we fast forward, inside the 3-minute mark, and there's a nice throw out to Sammy as he has 49 yards on 3 receptions. So here on a 1st and 10, here is Champagne Green getting open, and he's getting a gain of 8 on this one, and he's moving the sticks on this one. And once again, here's another throw, Jay Taylor, and that's a gain of about 5 yards. And now we're in business inside the 15-yard line. So from the shotgun, here's Tulevski. He's going to roll out to the right. He's going to buy some time. He's going to throw this one on the run. He's got Sammy. Touchdown. Number 4, Sammy Baldwin, our leading receiver on the season. Tulevski's 2nd touchdown throw of the game. That's an Aaron Rodgers-esque throw right there, directing his receiver away from traffic and getting in for the touchdown. So we do get one more shot here before the end of the first half. Here's a throw across the middle. That's Jay Taylor. He's got a lot of room, and he's picking up a gain of 25 as BYU has not done anything on offense. So here's Tulevski here from the shotgun. Another throw across the middle. This time it's Jordan Armstead who's getting going, a gain of 9. So 2nd and 1. Here's another play out to the left side. Throw to Jordan Armstead again. He's going to get inside the 20 on that one, as he gets taken down here with 10 seconds left. So snap from the 16-yard line. Tulevski, he's going to roll out to the right. He's going to throw out that way as well and find Denzel Knox, who almost fights his way in inside the pylon, but now we're at the 2. 2 seconds left. Handoff up the middle. Knox is in. Touchdown. And that's going to be his actually 10th touchdown of the season for him. And that is going to be a sizable lead as we move into the second half. 21-0, and now we move into the fourth, 24-3, as BYU is finally starting to show signs of life here. Nate Ward with his 2nd sack of the game. So now on a 3rd-19, here's a throw out to the right side. And that's Akusi who hangs on to it in traffic on a 17-yard catch, as we're just being greedy here, trying to run out the clock here on a 4th and 2, going for it. And Tulevski is going to drop back way too far. I don't know what we're doing on this one. And we get rid of it, and that's going to be a turnover there for Tulevski. And BYU actually capitalizes off of that drive, that short drive, and they make this a 10-24 game. Here's a throw out to the left side on the next drive, and it's picked off by Johnson again. And this time, he's taking it in for the touchdown, his 2nd interception of the game. Tony Johnson, and that is going to cut this lead down to just one touchdown here in the fourth quarter. So now from the pistol, here's a handoff. This time Knox picks up a block. He's around the corner. He's going to break a tackle and get past the 35-yard line on the opposite side of the 50. Nice blocking on that one by our offensive line, getting downfield to the second level and opening up that running room. So here's Daniel Dunn, who's coming off of a 100-yard game versus UCLA. He gets a gain of 7 on that. So here's Knox fighting his way, staying patient and picking up 9 as BYU is forced to use their timeouts now. So here from the pistol, counterplay. Here's Jay Taylor in the backfield. He's picking up a gain of 6 as they had to burn another one. So here's Denzel Knox. He's getting the carry. He's spinning his way in for the touchdown, 7 yards out, and Knox on that drive, 59 yards off of 7 carries, and he has a mammoth of a game in this one, 155 yards rushing, 2 touchdowns, and Akusi gets 89 yards on 6 catches for a touchdown as well. This was just a well-rounded game. We kind of collapsed towards the end, making bonehead mistakes, but we do hold on for the victory, and you can see, you know, our defense just continues to ball out. So here we go, going up against Kansas State. They aren't having the greatest of years. 2-4, 1-1 in the conference. Just basically a middle of the pack team, but they're led by Jeremiah McNair, a junior quarterback, 6'4, 231. Doesn't have the greatest of stats, but then they have a pretty decent running back, Chris Robinson, who's pretty much the workhorse. So we're going to see what he can do against us. So here's McNair starting out this next game, and he's going to scramble to the right side. As remember, he can run a little bit, as he's going to probably rely on his legs more than his arm. So here's a throw out to the middle of the field. Marcus Stevens getting going, and the senior that time gets about 10. So here's McNair, throw out to the right side. This time finding Haynes, and they're moving the ball quite well on this first drive. As you see, we do drop down in the rankings. NC State does jump us here. I don't know how long they're going to be above us, but because of that, I guess, close victory last week, I guess the committee said, hey, we're going to move them down to 4 and move NC State up to 3. So we do eventually get them to throw the ball out of the back of the end zone on an incomplete pass, as we do get the ball back on the kick return here, facing another tackle, facing one more tackle. Can he avoid another one? And Champagne Green is in. Touchdown. And man, he is just a return workhorse. I don't know what's gotten into him, but here this season, this guy has just been returning nothing but touchdowns, and we take the 7-3 lead here in this game. So here's Tulevsky on the next drive, throwing out to the right. That's incomplete. I'm not sure what's going on with Tulevsky. He's just been inaccurate the last couple of games, and it just hasn't been himself since the start of the year when he was just, you know, a little nervous, just having, you know, jitters. But now it's just being a habit. I mean, it's becoming a habit. I mean, Draymond Jennings last year was notoriously known for being pretty inconsistent, and I don't want Tulevsky to kind of inherit that reputation, as he does throw the ball across the middle. That one is deflected, but we do eventually pick up the first down here late in the second quarter. But this time facing some more pressure. Maybe it's this Kansas State defense that's doing it to him this game. I don't know. So here we are at the 3-minute mark here in the second quarter. Here's a throw across the middle, and it's picked off by Thompson. You can just see this defense is just hounding him this game as we try to fight back in this game and just try to get our offense going, as we do have the one-score lead or one-point lead going into 2 minutes left here in the second. And here's Sammy Baldwin. Maybe we just need to get our athletes involved. He gets a nice gain to the right side. Here is Knox. He finds a crease up the middle, and he gets a gain of 14 on this one, and that makes it a first down. Handoff to the left side. Jay Taylor this time. He's got to be patient on this one. He gets to the outside, though, and he's picking up 11 yards on that play. So here's Tulevsky. Draw play to the left side. Here's Knox breaking a tackle, and he's getting in for the touchdown. Avoids the tackler and fights his way in. 26 yards out, and that's a touchdown. So now we move into the second half of this game. Here is Denzel Knox with the carry up the middle, and he's coming off of a big 155-yard gain, and he's making his way inside the 15, 47 yards. And that's just great blocking on that one in the second level. So now here's Tulevsky on the next pass. Here's a throw out to the left side. He's got Raheem 6 yards out and a touchdown. And maybe we just need to get this running game going. We get 2 touchdowns here to start the second half. So here is Champagne Green, another return. He gets to the outside. Does he have the speed to get back past the second level? And he does! Another return for a touchdown. Champagne Green with a 2-touchdown performance. Man, this guy has already probably wrapped up Returner of the Year already through the first 5 games. Just amazing. So here is Sammy Baldwin getting going here in the fourth quarter, here in a 28-20 game, as Kansas State is just hanging around in this one, as we do get a nice gain from that play. And Denzel Knox finishes it off up the middle, picking up a 2-yard touchdown run as we take this lead 35-20. And we don't look back as we just finish out this game here. As Tulevsky has probably the worst game of his career. This Kansas State defense was actually really, really good. 4 interceptions. I didn't show all of them, but just a terrible game by him. But I just wanted to highlight the game that Knox had. 200 yards off of 22 attempts. What a game from him. And on the defensive side of the ball, we actually played a decent game. We gave up 20 points. But a lot of that was because we gave up field position with the interception. So I'm not too mad at our defense. So we do jump back up to number 3 after that win. It's because NC State actually loses to Florida State. So there are a couple of undefeated teams left still. And you know what? One of those is actually Cal. Remember, we moved Cal into the Mountain West Conference because they were struggling in the Pac-12, pretty much getting 2 wins in back-to-back seasons. So we decided to move them over to the Mountain West. And look at them. Now they're number 6 in the country, and they are one of the 4 undefeated teams left. So now we have a couple of teams left to jump. Maybe one of those teams can lose, and we'll jump up to number 1 or number 2 for the first time here in this series. So here is this next game, going up against Iowa State. Already down in a 10-0 hole as Sammy Baldwin gets going on offense. Here on our 1st and 10, here's a deep shot. And look who's wide open. It's Sammy Baldwin again. Touchdown. 52 yards. That's a perfect throw by Tulevsky. 3 of 6 to start this game. And Iowa State up 10-0, but we're not down by much here in the first quarter. So now in the second quarter, here is Hayden, their running back, Randy Hayden. And he is a junior running back. And remember, Iowa State usually breeds running backs. They're pretty good at producing running backs of good quality, and that's what's pretty much keeping them in this game, just running the ball. So Sammy Baldwin goes over 100 yards here in the first half on that catch. Here's another pass out to the left, and he's got another catch and run, 15 yards, adding to his total. So now inside the 20, here on a 2nd and 8, from the pistol, play action fake, Tulevsky. He's going to try to get rid of it, but he's sacked. 10-yard loss on that one by Alex Romero. So now a 3rd and 18. Man coverage to the right side. And that's almost caught and ran in for the touchdown, but a great defensive play there from Iowa State. So we do settle for the field goal. Then it follows up by a defensive score, and we get the ball back before half, and that's Daniel Dunn getting his first carry of the game. So now here's Tulevsky from the shotgun, trying to buy some time, rolling out to the right side. He's going to unload. He's got a man, Tyree Jordan, deep downfield, who tries to make a move, but he's inside the 10 on a 46-yard reception on that one. And that's a nice catch and a nice run for a big first down. So now we're inside the 5. Here's a handoff, Denzel. And we take the 2-score lead going into the second half off of that run as Iowa State trying to come back in this one. Here is Grant on the screen pass to Hayden this time. He's getting tackled by Zamir Hines, but that's actually going to be a face mask on the play. So they get another 15 yards on this one. So now 3rd and 6, down by 2 scores. Grant inside of field goal range. This time he's going to run out to the left side. He's going to pick up the first, swerving his way inside the 15. It was kind of hard to tell where he was going to run on that one. So now here on a 2nd and 11, here's Wiggins, their backup running back, avoiding a tackler somehow. And Mike Wiggins fights in for the 12-yard touchdown run. And that is going to be a 7-point lead here for SJSU as we try to kind of keep this lead going. So here is Jordan Armstead on the next catch. He's picking up 9 yards on that one to the outside, and that's almost a first down. So a 2nd and 1. Here's a play up the middle. There's Denzel Knox with a nice hole, and he gets free for the touchdown. Knox is having himself another one of those seasons. 49 yards up the middle and a touchdown. So now it's a 38-24 game here later in the third quarter, and Tulevsky not having enough time to throw this ball. Chris Webb has 3 sacks in this game. Our offensive line has not been doing a good job blocking as far as pass protection goes. But here on a 3rd and 25, here is Champagne Green getting going, and he avoids all tacklers, and he's off, and he's gone. Touchdown, 91 yards. And Champagne Green, what an episode he's having. All these return touchdowns, a couple of receiving touchdowns, even a rushing touchdown, and we go on to win this one 52-38 as Tulevsky throws for 388 yards, his career high. Denzel Knox only gets 10 attempts in this game for 80 yards, and what a game from Sammy Baldwin and Champagne Green. Both go over 100 yards, and I don't know how often that will happen, but Champagne Green is surprising me. I didn't think he was much of a receiver because he doesn't have the greatest of hands, but that speed and space is just tough to stop. As you can just see, Emmanuel Thomas actually has his first double-digit tackle game of his career, and it's nothing to Michael Cummings. He does it again. So we go 3-0 in this episode. We'll see if we make any moves next episode, if we move up to the number 2 or 1 spot. We'll see. I don't really know, but we do need one of those teams to lose in order for us to even have a shot at the national title. But we got to take care of business here in the Big 12. We got a lot of season left, so stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go.